In Genius Idea News, submitted by Push the Button, a chef launched a late night meal delivery service for strippers.
Nice.
That's, I mean, about time.
That's high.
And he comes in all of them?
Hopefully
it's not. Joe, why would you take it there?
Here we go.
Whoa. Thank you. Let's focus on that.
I hope it's diet food.
Oh, wow. So there's so much coming from this side of the room.
Well, no.
Steve has a good point.
I'm having their back so they can keep
it down. I hope it's diet so the strippers don't get fat.
No, but for them, they want that.
Exactly. Let me get, I got your back.
I got your back.
Because there's all unhealthy options at night.
Listen, Oregon, so this chef.
Oh, they have all the strippers.
She's from Portland. Mm-hmm. And so she said she got this really great idea to start this catering service for strippers would complain about having nowhere healthy to eat after her shift was over.
Oh, that's
true.
That's
when she started delivering meals to her friend at the strip club. Oh. And then soon other dancers wanted to get in on
after
that.
After a long days of twerking,
yep.
I need to have a salad in my system because I ain't trying to eat fucking Burger King at night.
It was only fast food, like just Taco Bell and like just really unhealthy shit. She's like, I don't want to be bloated and stuff. Like,
see? I knew it, and you all was haters.
Okay, I retract.
Being that you don't want strippers to get fat, because that's problematic
too. That was the intent.
Yeah, but I don't want them to get fat on the one hand, but on the other hand, I don't think that they want to get fat either.
You want to empower them to not get fat.
That's exactly right.
I think they just want to be healthy.
I feel the same way, though, because when I go on Postmates or whatever, like at 12 at night or 1, I'm like, it's just Taco Bell. I don't want Taco Bell.
Me too.
Ugh.
Okay. Maybe so, you shouldn't be eating so late.
That's what I was thinking, true. But strippers are working.
That's the thing, they get off their shift late.
I mean, it's burning cows, dude. They were burning hard cows.
She's suffering from insomnia.
Yeah,
true. All right, so she called it Meals for 6-inch Heels.
Cute.
Meals on Heels.
That's tight.
So, that's cute. Her name is Nikisha.
Oh, she delivers them on heels as well.
Yeah.
Nikisha.
Oh, okay.
Why so sexual?
What's on her menu?
Cute. I don't know, but it's healthy stuff.
Ooh, look at that. There's some cilantro.
It does look like pho. I don't know.
I love her.
But yeah.
Aww.
This is a genius idea.
It's just for the hoes?
Yeah.
Oh.
It says fueling Portland sex workers.
So I wonder how you get to that.
That's kind of mean.
So right now she's actually a one-woman team.
What about the late-night crack hits?
They could order.
So she's saying that she's a one-woman show. She cooks and delivers each of the 20-plus orders she gets weekly. She is interested in
So you pre-order.
Yeah.
It's a cash business, too. I'm sure they got a lot of cash, too. That's tight.
Yeah, and strippers are rich.
That's good for Texas.
I mean, strippers aren't necessarily rich. It depends.
They ballin' according to the world. Like world poverty rates and shit.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, they got money, but the amount of money that they should get that they don't, like at the end of a shift when you have to tip out like the bartender and the DJ and all the things, it's insane. It's like, I'm over here showing you my pussy. Like, why?
Yeah. I mean, it shouldn't be 10% and 10% and 10% and 10% and then you walk out with like 5.
I heard some top notch ones make like 40 grand a month.
Mm-hmm.
40? Mm-hmm. Damn.
That's very nice.
So that's cool. So it doesn't say what's on her menu?
Let me pull up her website. Let me see. In the meantime, you guys.
I love this. This is brilliant. Yourselves.
Jess, you could meal prep and then you'll have healthy food.
That's true.
That's what I do. I already get enough shit from people that I don't cook. I don't need to hear it from you. Oh. I was just making a suggestion.
I don't need your suggestions.
Making a suggestion.
I don't need your suggestions.
I'm going to help out a friend, you know.
Just restrictive diet and I had to do that. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'll start cooking now. Now that I'm not in a relationship
anymore,
I'll really
have a bunch of
time. I put
really easy recipes just now on my Tasty Tuesday video. You should check them out. Yeah.
But I like to eat meat.
You could add meat.
Okay.
You could add meat to any of that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty easy.
Just saying, there are solutions in this world.
My friend added chicken to the quinoa salad.
Where are they? She's over there.
What?
I wonder how she makes sure that it's just, you know, she wants to be exclusive just for sex workers. So how does she make sure?
Maybe depending on what time she has to be delivering, like if it's at 4 a.m., cool.
Well, she also, it sounds like she makes 20 meals, so she probably just delivers to the strip club.
Right, it seems like she knows exactly
she
the girl.
Delivers, yeah.
Yeah, and she's like, okay.
That's a really small customer base.
Yeah.
I wonder if she only hands out business cards, so like the only way you can make an order is like if you have her specific
number. She's looking to expand, she said, so.
So now she's gonna move on to prostitutes?
That would be the smart.
Well, she'd have to hire like a sous chef or some delivery person or something. Like, I would hire those people first before expanding my business.
Okay,
There's cam girls too, because they stream late.
But cam girls can stream any hour.
Yeah, and they could also like order.
True.
Yeah, in their house, they got a fridge.
But it's all bad food at night.
Yeah, bad food.
But like me, can I order from this lady?
Why don't you order at 8 p.m., keep that meal in your fridge, and then you have
it. It has to be fresh.
If you order Postmates, even as a webcam girl, like, you don't want to get dressed and then like open the door. If you know it's her and she's cool, you could just walk up there with a dildo in your pussy still, and you open up and you're like, thanks, you got to get back to your stream, you know?
That's really
You could
true.
Still stay like busy.
You really think like this girl can't take the dildo out of her pussy to go into the door?
She's working.
She's working, yeah.
That's an ignorant statement.
She's on the job.
No fantasy.
Well, I'm just thinking they're hard working and like sometimes I get too busy and I'm just like.
You can't take that dildo out. Ain't nobody got time for that.
It's in there. It's in. I'm not gonna do this. Why?
I think I totally understand your point.
Yeah. It's a good point.
I do that. I get bothered when I order Postmates and I have to put clothes on.
Oh my God, it's the worst.
I tell them to leave it on the porch.
That's the smartest idea because you don't want people necessarily to know where you live.
That's true.
Or what you look like.
So it doesn't seem like she has a website.
You know, lately I've been, this thought has been entering my mind that like, what if someone knew where you lived and they wanted to poison you? Anyone could poison any Postmates delivery. Like there should be some sort of there should be some sort of system
like
with
sealable?
Postmates where it's sealed.
Yeah.
The people at the restaurant seal it.
Wait, but who would poison you?
Huh?
Like if they found out where you lived with your enemies.
Like if you're a Russian spy.
Or what if it was just a random person that was like
fun? Like that guy that was jacking off into like the food at different places.
Just
balls in
the salt. Oh, great. Now I'm not going to fucking order HIV. Food anymore.
No, yeah, you
and
will.
You looked at me weird when I said this guy's trying to cum on everybody's food.
Good point. We judged
Email.
You.
Well, that
And that was problematic, I will say.
This guy, and he had HIV, and then people ate it, and then they got HIV.
Oh, that's sad.
Oh, shit.
Okay, well listen, the internet here sucks. She does have a website, I can't pull it up.
Nice.
Dang, our internet is bad.
I always thought about that because like, you know, a lot of people are insomniacs now, but they should be healthy too.
Yes, true.
And just because they can't sleep doesn't mean-
They should especially be healthy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they need nutrients.
Why can't fast food be, why can't I do a drive-thru of something healthy?
Yeah.
I hate that.
Everything in Texas has a fucking drive-thru, I swear. Nothing in LA has a drive-thru.
It's because of demand, bro. There ain't no demand for it, unfortunately.
Yeah, who craves a salad at 3 a.m.?
Right. Drunk people don't, do you?
I don't drink, so maybe that's why.
I don't either, but.
I think that's what it is, though. You're being smart at 3 a.m. and most people are like, I'm drunk, I want something fucking greasy.
I think like at 3 a.m. I want a salad. During the day, I want pizza and french fries and like a grilled cheese.
Really?
Wow. You're the opposite.
Depends what my cravings are.
I see.
Yeah.
Produce can go bad quickly, so maybe that's why, and it's expensive.
Yeah, it's all a price point thing.
That's why.
Because healthy food is expensive.
Yeah. Here, I'll show you guys the website.
Oh my God.
Sorry, editor, I can't get this for you. But just use the screen. Okay, hold on.
It says bomb.
Let me make it.
So it's vegan.
Right. So, yeah, I mean, you could see the dishes.
So you wouldn't like it anyway, Jeff.
Through this. There's little.
It's vegan?
No, so she has.
No, she also said there's like chicken.
Yeah, there's
but
options.
She has these
like,
options.
Healthy options.
I see that? I feel like it's a bouquet and I can't eat it.
Ooh. You just see it and you're like, that shit looks pretty. I can't.
Yeah, it looks like flowers and it doesn't look delicious to me.
Her website is dope.
Yeah, it's pretty slick.
Yeah.
It looks good though, but no, I'm not talking about her food, but like whenever I see that kind of style, I'm like, what do I do with it? There's like a flower and some grass.
Oh, it looks like a bouquet tea.
I've never seen that. Like, because you could go to sushi restaurants and get vegan sushi, like avocado rolls, miso soup, soybeans. Like, that's a whole meal and it's vegan, but.
Yeah, but I know he's talking about some LA places have like wheatgrass and shit.
No, but the way that it's presented, it's actually very nice. Like it's artistic and all that, but it's intimidating to
eat it
because it's not food in my head. Like I look at it and I'm like, man, this just looks like art. Yeah. I don't know, and I don't know what I'm gonna taste. So like, you know how you have that flavor in your head or in your mouth when you look at a hamburger, you're like, I know what that's gonna taste.
So you're talking about like pates or some shit.
No, he's just talking about like food that is extravagantly presented.
Yeah.
When there's like. You've got like a little blossom flower, a little something, cilantro sprinkles just on the top. It's like.
Yeah, I don't know what to go, am I craving this?
You have to like mix it all
together.
Yeah,
there's like beans and grass. Like, I don't know, like.
Beans and grass? Yeah.
Is it gonna taste like lime? I don't know, like.
Or just dig in and find out.
Yeah, I don't know, but when I'm looking for food and I'm feeling healthy, I look at it and I always skip it because I just don't have.
Really, the sauces are everything. Yeah. Like you put some tahini sauce on anything and it tastes pretty good.
Maybe, yeah. But if I see a chicken, like, Caesar salad, I'm like, I know what that tastes like, right. And I'm thinking about it. I could eat that right now.
Yeah.
What's the word? It doesn't look,
appetizing?
Appetizing
yeah.
to you.
Yeah, it's not. Maybe I gotta actually eat it.
Yeah, and then you'll start registering it and be like, oh, I know what that tastes like.
Yeah.
And then now you'll know that it tastes like stripper food.
Yep.
That's pretty cool.
This is
that's
the same.
Mom, I love her. What's her name?
Nikisha.
Nikisha.
Yeah, Nikisha Newton.